Hello friends, welcome back to our tutorial, Designing an Impressive Architectural Building in Revit 2018 Metro. Click the File tab and hover the mouse cursor to save as. Select Project. Rename this file to 00_013_DIAB_M and click the Save button. Use a window selection to select all of the walls in this project. Click the filter button, check none and check the wall. Select apply, click OK. Go to the clipboard panel and select the copy command. Go to the project browser and double click the first floor view. Click the down arrow under the paste command and select align to select level. Select the first floor plan and click OK. Revit align the copy object into this level. I'm going to click undo and switch to the default 3D view so that you can see the operation immediately in a 3D view. But before I do, I'm going to change the view detail to fine and the visual style display to shaded. Now click the down arrow under the copy command and select align to selected level. Select first floor view and click OK. Revit copy this project into the first floor. Now go to the project browser and double click the first floor view. Click the modify button to deselect this project. Zoom in into this area. Select this wall and hit delete on your keyboard. Select this wall, hit delete on your keyboard. Hover the mouse cursor and press it to this wall and press the tab key. Click, hit delete on your keyboard. Select this, hold control key and select this, hit delete. Hover the mouse cursor into this wall and press the tab key. Click, hit delete on your keyboard. Now go to the default 3D view to see the results. Go to the top right corner of the window and click the explore to close this view. Now right click the wall and select create similar. Draw a wall from this point to this point. Press escape. Go to the quick access toolbar and select the align dimension command. Align the edge of this wall to this wall. Click to place a dimension. Click the modify button. Select this wall and enter a value of 4500 millimeter. Press enter. Select the trim extend to corner. Select this wall and this wall. Change this value to 4800 millimeter. Press enter. Select this wall. Select the trim extend to corner. Select this wall and this wall. Click the modify button. Use a window selection, click on this area and select all this object. Click the filter button, uncheck the wall and click apply, click OK. Hit delete to delete this window. Select this window and hit delete. Select the door, delete this door. Select this door and move this door to the right. Use the arrow key to merge this door to the left. Click to deselect. Now go to the default 3D view to see the results. Close this view. Select this door. Zoom in into this area. Select this wall. Hold down the control key and select this wall. Hit delete. The wall deleted with the hosted objects around the door. Now select this valley, this wall, and move the witness line to the core face of this wall. Change the value to 3600. Press enter. With the wall still selected, select the grid similar command and draw another wall from this point to this point. Press escape. Select this wall and change the value to 1650 millimeter. Press enter. Now right click this wall and select grid similar. Draw another wall from this point to this point. Press escape. Select the trim extend to corner. select this line and this line, select this this wall and this wall, click on join, click delete instant, click modify, select this half wall and hit delete on your keyboard. Now select this wall and click the witness line, align it to the core face of this wall and change the value to 3450 millimeter. Press enter. Select this window and change its type to 750 by 750 millimeter. Change the seal height to 1500 millimeter. Click to deselect. Use the align dimension command. Select the core face of this wall, the core face of this wall, this wall, this, this, and this wall. Move down to place the dimension. Click the modify button. Select this wall and change this value to 1200 millimeter. Click the trim extend single element. Click on the face of this wall and extend this wall. Click the split element command. Check the delete inner segment and split this wall from this point to this point. Click the modify button. Now select this wall and click the down arrow. Select the my generic wall 100 millimeter. Click the align button on the modify panel and change the align. Change the placement to core, to face of core. Select the face of this core and the core face of this wall. Click the modify button. Right click this wall, grid similar, draw another wall from this point to this point. Press escape. Right click this wall, grid similar, draw another wall from this point to this point. Press escape. Select this wall and change this value to 600 millimeter. Click to place. Select this wall, change this value to 600 millimeter. Select the door and notch this door up. Now right click this wall, select grid similar, start a wall from this point and draw this wall at an angle of 45 degrees. Select the trim extend to corner. Select this wall and trim to this wall. Select this wall and trim to this wall. Click the modify button. Select the door and click grid similar. Place the door into this wall. Click the modify button. Select the door and change the door type to single flush door 30. Select 762 by 2134 millimeter. Click out. Go to the project browser. Select the underlaying and set it to none. Zoom out to see the result. Select the dimension, right click, select all instant visible view, hit delete on your keyboard. Select this door and hit delete on your keyboard. Select this door and hit delete on your keyboard. Select this window, go to the modify panel and select the mirror pick axis. Zoom in and pick the axis of this window to mirror the window to the other side. Select this door and click the delete command. Now right click this wall, grid similar, draw a wall from this point to this point and draw a wall to this point. Click the extend single element, select the core face of this wall and extend this wall to that direction. Now select this door and hit delete on your keyboard. Right click this wall, grid similar, draw another wall from this point to this point. Click on the flip arrow to flip it to the other side. Click the witness line and move it to the face of this wall. Click this witness line and move it to the core face of this wall. Change the value to 600 millimeter. Press enter. Click the modify button. Right click the reference plane, select grid similar, draw a reference pin from this point to this point. Select the align dimension corner. Select the face of this wall, the face of this wall, and click this reference pin. Move the dimension and click to place. Click the EQ button. Click the modify. Select this wall. Hold down the control key and select this wall. Go to the modify panel and select the narrow peak axis. Click this reference pin to narrow this wall in the opposite side. Select the trim extend multiple element. Select the core face of this wall and trim this wall. Trim this wall. Click the modify button. Select the split command and split this wall at the center. Select the trim extend to corner. Select this wall, this wall. Select this wall, this wall. Click the modify button. Select the window, hold down control key and select this window. Hit delete on your keyboard. Select this door and move this door to the left. Select the trim extend to corner. Select this wall, this wall, this wall, this wall. Zoom in into this area. Select the trim extend single element. Select the office of this wall. Click this wall to extend it to this wall. Click the modify button. Zoom out, right click the reference plane and select grid similar. Draw a reference plane from this point to this point. Click the modify button. Dimension this reference, this core face of this wall to this reference plane. Move down to place a dimension. Click the modify button. Select the reference plane and change this value to 150 mm. Click to place the value. Now select the split command. Split this wall from this point to this point. Click the trim extend single element. Select this reference plane and trim off this wall. Select the face of this wall and extend this wall. Click the modify button. Now right click this wall and select grid similar. In the option bar, change the location line to core face. Change the extension line to core face exterior. Click on this point. If the wall orient in the wrong direction, press the space bar on your keyboard. Move the wall and draw it into 45 degree angle. The distance isn't important at this moment. Click to draw the wall. Now select the trim extend to corner. Select this wall and this wall. Select the trim extend single element. Click the face of this wall and this wall. Click the modify button. Select this wall, change this value to 1200 mm. Click to see this wall. Flip the wall outside. Move the witness line to the core face of this wall. And move this witness line to the core face of this wall. Click the modify button to deselect the object. Right click this wall. Grid similar. Zoom in into this area. Draw a wall from this point. Move and draw a wall to this point. Press escape. One, start a wall from this corner and snap into 45 degree angle. Click. Select the trim extend to corner. Select this wall and this wall. Click the modify button. Select this wall and change the value to 500 millimeter. Click to place the value. Now select this door. Select edit type and select rename. Change the value to 2100. Change this one to 750. Click OK. Now make sure that the value match to what we have changed to match with the name. Change this to 2100 and change this value to 750. Click duplicate, delete this two and change this value here to 600. Click OK. then change this value to match the 600, the width value to 600. Click on any other input and click OK. Now change the door, click the down and select the 750. You see the door updates. Select create similar, place this door here and flip this door to the other side, place this door, click the modify button, select this door, hold down the control key and select this door, change this door type to 600 by 2100 millimeters. Right click this door and select grid similar, place a door into this wall and this wall, click the modify button, go to the architectural tab and select the door command, click the down arrow and shut for the closet, select the door 00_008_DIAB_M and select the 1200 by 2400, move into this area and place this door, click the down arrow, select and place this door into this closet, click the modify button, zoom in into this area, select this door and notch this door to the right, or use the dimension command, select the face of this wall and the center of the door, move down to place the dimension, click the EQ button, click the modify button to deselect, select the dimension and hit delete on your keyboard, click on constraint, select this door, go to the modify panel, select the mirror pick axis, click the center of this wall to mirror the door to the closet door to the opposite side. Now select this door, click the down arrow and change the type to 2400 by 2100, notch this door up, notch it up. Now go to the ground floor plan, select this wall, flip this wall to the opposite side, copy this wall, go to the first floor plan, click the modify button, click the down arrow under paste command and select align to the selected level, select the first floor plan view, click OK to align this wall into this other wall. Now select the extend single element, click the face of this wall and click to move to extend this wall, select the trim extend to corner, click this wall and this wall, click the modify button, select this portion and hit delete on your keyboard, select this door and notch this door to the left, click to place the door, select the trim extend to corner, select this wall, click the modify button, hover your mouse cursor to this wall and press the tab key, hit delete on your keyboard to delete the wall. Now select the right click the double window and select grid similar, place a double window into this area and one to this area, paste another window into this area, click the modify button, select the window. Now go to the quick access toolbar, go to the project browser, click the edit next to view range and change the view range to 1500 millimeter, click apply, click OK. Now select this window, change its type to 900 by 1200, with the window still selected, select grid similar and select this wall to create another window into this wall, click the modify button. If you repeat, ask you to save the project, go ahead and save the project. Now right click this toilet window and select grid similar, place a window into this toilet and another window into this toilet, click the modify button, right click this window, grid similar, please select this wall to paste a window to this wall and this wall to paste a window to this wall, click the modify button, go to the default 3D view to see the results so far. Hold down the shift key on your keyboard and your middle mouse button to orbit around the model. Click the X button to close this window. Go to the navigation bar and click zoom to fit or type ZF on your keyboard. Go to the quick access toolbar and click the save button. We're going to end this video here. If you like this tutorial, please click the like button and share it to your friend. If you have any question or suggestion, please leave a comment below. If you want to continue this tutorial or any other tutorial on my channel, please subscribe. Don't forget to click the bell so that you can be notified when I upload a new tutorial. Thanks very much for watching. I hope to see you in the next class. Goodbye.